Timothy Jones, and I will be presenting you a presentation on prescription drugs, and more specifically, should the prices be regulated. For years, I've watched my dad battle with diabetes and all of the medication he needs, as far as insulin shots and just any of the pills that he has to take. From the beginning of him being diagnosed until now, those prices have more than doubled, and the prices in America are just outrageous compared to what others pay in the world.
Per capita, America pays
2 times more than the next highest country. And one specific instance is the drug Humira, which costs 3 times more here than in Switzerland. And there were a lot of other countries that had it way cheaper as well. The sources that I used were CNN, Facts on File, and Statista. And not even just
comparing us to other countries. We can compare us to ourselves.
In 1990, we only spent $40 billion in pharmaceutical drugs
for the entire year. And in
2019, we spent 9 times that amount, which is it's just insane. And today I subscribe to you that America has the ability and the civic duty
to continually regulate prescription drug prices and start programs to where we can better assist
and take care of the people. Those who disagree might say that the price of the drugs has to correlate with the cost of research and development, which is a valid reason. And they also say the more we pay, the more they can regulate and ensure the safety, the more testing that can be done and all of that. And also they try to say that we shouldn't import drugs from other countries because, again, the safety reason, like we can't really regulate it as much as we want to, or
it might be tampered with or anything of that nature. But also, but studies have shown that
A lot of the money is actually going to advertising, and a lot of it is kind of predatory advertising practices, such as $15 billion in educational seminars where doctors go and they get bombarded with a lot of advertising about all the new drugs and all the most expensive drugs that are coming out. So they make sure that the doctors have that in their head over and over again. And studies have shown that the more familiar that a doctor is with the prescription,
that's what they're going to prescribe. Not even just that, but also
all of the TV advertisements. And they also give away free samples at these seminars, and they spend billions on giving out free samples.
And then they so the doctors again will be
more familiar with it, so that's what they're going to
prescribe instead of these generic brands, which are actually the same exact medicine because the formula has to be the same
legally. As far as the FDA goes. And also another thing about these prescription drug companies is they spend a lot of money on influencing those in power, or influencing those who create the laws. And this, as far as this graphic, in 2018, they gave $7 million to the Republican Party, which is the more pro-business party that will pass legislation that will lean more towards what they have going on and more towards the big corporations. Instead of
they spent $2 million more over in the
Republican Party than they did with the Democratic Party.
And even in the Democratic Party, there are some
people that will pass legislation for the pharmaceutical company. So that's really where all that money is coming from. They donated to 209 people in the Republican Party and 185
in the Democratic Party.
And statistics from the Center for Responsive Politics in 2000 shows that showed that the pharmaceutical research and manufacturers of America donated 4 times more to the Republican Party than to any into anyone who opposed anything that they had going on as far as the regulation of prices. And I subscribe to you a few plans and a few solutions we could implement in our country that I've seen in other countries that I looked at. We could make importation
of pharmaceutical drugs legal,
which would also in turn have the government have a hand in it, so they can regulate it
and they can make sure things have not been tampered with, because
it's better than if it's illegal and people are going to do it anyway. People are going to import these drugs anyway. If you do it illegally, it's way more dangerous, it's way more
risky. You could
tamper with drugs, you might not be getting the drug that you paid for or trying to get. It might not be the same formula and things of that
nature. This would
greatly allow the government to monitor
all of that activity.
And also, Medicare and its millions of Medicare recipients and all of the millions of people that that use that service, they have a lot of, they could use their leverage. That's a lot of leverage. If you have millions of people buying, that need to buy drugs, you can just have a strike in a way. Have a strike and move. Say we're gonna
use
our leverage to make these guys, make these pharmaceutical companies pay, charge less for all of these drugs. I'm sure there's something that can be done in that aspect as well. That's just a couple plans that could be implemented, besides just the fact that the government saying, okay, this is not okay.
We need to
lower these prices. We need to make them be affordable. Today I've given you a few reasons to believe the U.S. government should regulate the pharmaceutical companies instead of working with them,
which
we see here. And we as a first world country
have a civic duty and a
moral duty to push for fairness and fairness from those who
have been
elected to represent us from the top all the way to the bottom. We have to make sure that we're taking care of all of our people. The most important incentive the government should be worried about, really the only incentive the government should be worried about,
is keeping us healthy and keeping us safe from predatory business practices,
especially those that inhibit our safety